you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game, nerds.
We have to insult them anyway as we leave.
DVD, check. Next stop, chemistry class.
Joy. That was cool.
It was fun nerding out with these two. Especially when I kicked that dirt dude's ass at the end.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks again for the game, Chloe.
Super fun. Next time, we'll be even better.
Yeah, hopefully I don't die. That was awesome. I would literally play a game like that. A game of people playing a game. We could just sit around a table, like, not actually playing a game, but having, you know, a character in this game explaining what happens in the game we're playing in the game. You guys know what I mean. Okay, we talked to everybody, so...
If I'm late to class, that's just one more excuse for Mom to sick David on me.
I really didn't mean anything.
Okay. Let's not have David sicked on us. That would make me literally sick to have him sicked. Oh!
What the hell?
Watch it!
What have you got here, Twitch? Don't call me that!
True North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap, Prescott.
Huh.
It's not yours! Give it back! I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
He's a lot younger. You're both losers.
Guys, no need to fight. You can both be losers.
The mute speaks?
I'm not mute.
Whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Oops.
Wow. Dick move, Nathan.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down.
Oh.
And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone.
You know something, Prescott? I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
His pictures?
You're a piece of shit. I am going to kill you.
You guys, stop.
We have to stop him?
Do something. Don't just stand there watching.
I'll do something.
The only way to stop a bully is to be aggressive. I've got to put Drew down.
Back off, idiot.
What the hell did you just say to me?
Called you an idiot. Idiot?
Idiot? You're not used to a word that big, are you? Don't be scared.
Hmm?
You're seriously defending Nathan Prescott?
He's an easy target.
How about picking on someone your own size? Which I hear is pretty small.
Whoop.
You're such a crazy freak. Mind your own business.
What if he cries to Daddy?
When Nathan goes crying to Lord Prescott, everybody here will be stuck doing sensitivity seminars all week.
You want a piece of this?
Not really.
I don't want a piece of that. I just want us all to get along, preferably without ever interacting.
Ooh.
All hey. Talk. No game, huh, Chloe?
Oh. Does that mean I failed that one? I guess so.
Booyah! That took me months to put together!
Quit the team, Twitch. For your own good.
If I were him, I'd punch him anyway.
Shit.
If I was
next time,
Prescott.
Mind your own business.
Yeah, I guess that didn't
welcome.
Turn out so well.
Thanks for sticking up for him. People think just because of his family.
Everything okay here?
Yeah, now.
No problem, Skip.
You're a little late. Oh god, consequences. Wait. Okay, that's from last night. Okay. Glad we talked, she says. Me too. Mom says, I know you're doing your best. Love you. Okay. So the only thing is, we can't... Oh, wait, wait. Duh, I just noticed this on top. And I think it was like this in the game, too. We can get to our text at any time. Sorry, guys. You guys are probably yelling at me. So I got more pages now. So let's read this, and we'll, of course, we'll go to these other things. 5-7-2010. You know how things with Mom seemed like they couldn't get any worse? Huh. The sad truth is I suddenly have to choose between being nice or being honest with her, because I can't be both. But how can I keep being nice and pretending like she didn't make a horrible choice with Mustache? And why am I the only one concerned about this hostile takeover of our house? Today it's a toolbox and pot roast. Tomorrow it's... I should stop there for sanity's sake. Honestyville and Niceburg. And yeah... Oh, there's a picture. A drawing of her, mom's purse. And yeah, I know Mom is stressed about money issues, but that still doesn't justify her horrible taste in men. Also, Mom knows I've been skipping, which sucks, but in a way does... In a way makes me feel better about it. Does that make me a bad person? That I don't feel bad about leaping off? Or just relieved that I don't have to waste the energy to lie about it anymore? On second thought, don't answer that. Chloe, the no-good, very bad person. Well, you're not a bad person. So the mustache drove me to school today. Yep, that's what my life's become. Even worse, he thought the ride was like a tell-me-how-things-are-going-to-be from now on opportunity. I shut that shit down real quick, but I have a feeling he's gonna run crying to Mom about it, because that's the kind of little man baby he is. Had a dream about Dad again, the one where I was there when it happened. It seems to get harder and harder after each of these to remember what's real and what's not. Also, she wasn't there when it happened. All I can remember after I wake up is how much I miss him. I hope that never goes away. The Chloe who wasn't there, or was I? Now remember, if we... When Max changed the past, so that her father was still alive, she, Chloe, ended up the one in the car accident and was actually wheelchair-bound and I think hooked up to oxygen and stuff, and she wanted to die. She wanted Chloe to, you know, assist her death and stuff, and I wouldn't choose that. There was no way. Okay, we got stuff. Stuff to read and more stuff to uncover. Okay, so I'm going to read all this stuff. Hope you guys don't mind. My name is Chloe Price, but you can call me, middle finger. I am an inmate at Blackwell Academy, currently serving a 4-year sentence for crimes against maternity. That would be my mom, Joyce, who seems endlessly disappointed in me. Which, I get it. I'm no one's image of a perfect daughter, or student, or anything really, but who the bleep wants to be perfect? I'm surrounded all day by so-called perfection, and it sucks ass. Other things that sucks. Mom's new drill sergeant boyfriend, David. How hard it is to buy weed around here. Having no friends. Hypocrites. Country music. People who say chillax. Dad being dead. So she doesn't like country music? I guess maybe it reminds her of her father. It's been 2 years since he died in the car crash, and I still think about him all the time. I've even been having these weirdly lifelike dreams. Sometimes I think he's trying to tell me something. Other times I remember that he's feeding worms in a ditch right now, and anything else is just a fairy tale to make myself feel better. At least I have two weapons to help me survive this shitburg town. The pen I use to tag any and everything I want, and my shining personality. If I work at it, maybe I can leave this place just a little less perfect than when I found it. Next. Okay. So, Juno has... Okay. I guess everyone has a same amount of pages? Yeah, why not? I was in it. Drew North is Mikey's older brother, and the two of them couldn't be more different. Drew is a legit jock, like the type that spends hours a day in the gym and has nicknames for his biceps. I've never been to a Bigfoot's game, but I hear he's actually good at throwing stuff into other stuff or whatever. Basketball goes into hoop. Football goes into butt, pretty sure. Mikey told me that Drew is planning to go to college on an athletic scholarship, which is good because their family is even poorer than mine. Their dad was one of the fishermen who lost his job because of the Prescott Corporation. As you might imagine, this put Nathan on Drew's shit list. Not a good list to be on. In the war between a meathead and a shithead, does anyone win? Anyway, I don't think Drew's really a bad guy, but I guess I wouldn't know. It's like we exist in two completely different planes of existence that happen to be in the same school. Happy to keep it that way. So I'm going to go into individually now. Max. Max Caulfield, MIA ex-best friend extraordinaire. This artsy mother bleeper loves photography more than life itself, and definitely more than me. She even uses old instant cameras. It's probably not healthy for anyone to be that stuck in the past, but who am I to tell people how to live their lives? When we were kids, we were dressed like pirates and eat ice cream and write and draw these stupid comic books where we had powers and save people and shit. Super Kitty is trapped. We must save her. Meow. Then my dad died, and her dad got some job up north, and she moved away to Seattle. It was probably the moment where I needed her most, and she bailed. Thanks, Max, for teaching me that I can't rely on anyone. I mean it. Life lesson learned. Hey, Chloe. The worst part is, even though we haven't spoken in months, even though she habitually ignored my text so much that I just stopped trying, even though I know deep down that she doesn't care about me anymore and that she probably has all new friends up in bleeping Seattle, I still miss her. If she came back tomorrow and said, "Hey, Chloe, want to dress up like pirates and be stupid together?" I would take her back in a heartbeat. In a heartbeat. Lub-dub. And I guess you do, kinda. David and Joyce. Don't put them together. Despite my mom's best efforts, I don't actually hate her. I know shit's been rough since Dad died. Money's tight, her job as a waitress at a diner isn't exactly glamorous, and I'm clearly not all about the whole going to school thing. But why does she have to make things so much harder on the both of us? She acts like if I smoke pot, or when I skip out to go catch an awesome show, it's somehow a personal attack on her. She should be happy that I'm self-medicating and not going postal on everyone. She never used to be this way when Dad was around. She could actually be cool. Punk rock benefit show. No bozos. 16 plus $5. Okay. But lately there's a hairy bleep monster she let in the house that's bleeping everything up. Sorry guys, I don't want to curse this much. David Mattson, a jobless, brainless, little shit with a hard-on for the military and a promise to whip me into shape. Asshole. Okay, that's a thingy thing on a treadmill. Yeah, that's pretty imaginative. I've tried to express these concerns to my mom, yet every week it seems the virus spreads to yet another corner of her life. I'm starting to worry that the David flu is the kind of disease that kills its host. Certainly has a way with words. William. If I had a nickel bag for every jerk-off guidance counselor or therapist who tried to get me to write shit about Dad over the last couple of years, I would never have to buy weed from Frank again. What's the matter? Don't you want to write your dear old Dad? That's horrible. I guess they think it helps me cope with my feelings or whatever, as if a few paragraphs about how great Dad was could help me forget that his guts are probably still plastered to the underside of a semi-truck. I'm sure they clean that up, actually. And what the bleep am I supposed to write anyway? That he was the perfect dad, who was always fun to be around and never angry? That he treated me like an equal? That he was constantly working to make our lives better? That he could always make me laugh, even when I was being a bitch? That he sang in the shower and hated hypocrisy, and that his barbecue grill is still rusting in the backyard, because the thought of either throwing it away or ever using it again are both so painful that it's easier for Mom and me just to pretend neither of us notices it? That last line was very long. If that's coping here, then coping can go bleep itself. Elliot. Yes, exactly how do we feel about Elliot? As far as Blackwell students go, Elliot Hampton is pretty not terrible. He hangs out with some of the douchers sometimes, but I get the sense that he's mostly a lone wolf, like this chick. Similar to my class schedule, Elliot and I have history, but no chemistry or drama. We hooked up a few times shortly after Dad died, but there wasn't really much to it. I think I was just bored, or maybe a little lonely. Weird, I know. His chemistry. I don't always get where Elliot's coming from. He's constantly asking to do stuff with me, which is nice, but I'm not sure we have that much in common anymore. Sometimes when we talk, it seems almost like he's studying me. I can't tell if he actually wants to be friends or just get in my pants. I guess I should be flattered either way, but I'm also not sure how much I care. Sorry, Elliot. Sup? Frank. For a drug dealer, Frank Bowers is actually pretty chill. He likes to act like he's a tough guy, but I have no doubt that he's done a few messed up things over the years. But to me, he's like a scruffy dog. The tougher he tries to come off, the cuter he seems. Really? I've been buying weed from Frank for close to a year. I almost never have enough money to pay him, and he always tells me, "It's the last bleeping time, Chloe, I'm not your bleeping friend." Then he always gives it to me anyway. Like I said, guy's adorable. Of course, if I ever did anything to actually get on Frank's bad side, he might not seem so cuddly anymore. I hear Frank rolls with some dudes who are into darker shit than keeping high schoolers medicated. It's hard to imagine Frank getting mixed up with anything really bad, but I guess you never know. For now, I'll just keep hoping that Frank is even worse at remembering who owes him money than he is at being intimidating. Frank, date of birth, old, male. Mikey and Steph. Has kissed girls, has not kissed ever. Cool. I can never decide if Steph is the coolest or nerdiest people in all of Blackwell. Maybe both? Both. She's definitely queen of the indoor kids with all their weird role-playing games and sci-fi shit. That's awesome, though. I guess her dad is a video editor. She makes some sweet cash by selling bootleg DVDs. Don't knock the hustle. And I'm pretty sure Steph does all the backstage technical work for the school plays, which checks out. Another thing about Steph, she's into girls and she doesn't give a shit what anyone else thinks about it. Awesome. Sixth level, flaming gauntlet of awesomeness. I love it. Mikey North is the captain of Steph's fan club, and the two of them can be found huddled around tables, rolling 20-sided dice whenever they have the chance. If life were one of those... Ooh, sorry guys. If life were one of those 80s movies Dad used to watch, Mikey would be the nerd that the jocks give wedgies to. In the real world, if someone messed with Mikey, they'd be in deep shit. Mikey's older brother is Drew North, Blackwell's alpha jock. Oh! They're brothers? Oh, okay. Didn't know that. The truth is, Mikey is one of the few genuinely nice people in his place, although every once in a while he says something that reveals a darker outlook on life. No idea where he gets it from. Maybe Star Trek? Now, I'm pretty sure these two are new to the series. I do not remember them at all. Oh, and I meant to actually go back out to this. So we looked at all these. Wait, we looked at all of them already, except for Nathan. Nathan Prescott is the golden child of the Prescotts, Arcadia Bay's oldest, wealthiest, and most powerful family, as they love reminding everyone. Nathan's dad does something nautical-related. I think it has to do with murdering baby seals and turning them into death rays for the military. But I can't remember the details. Whatever the case, there's a lot of people in this town who hate the Prescotts, including all the fishermen he put out of work. And you do not want to mess with fishermen. They smell. Nathan is odd. He's extremely privileged, yet dark and brooding. Even though he's a dick, I can't help feeling bad for him sometimes. He's really just a weird little dude, trying to figure out his shit, but he has to pretend to be all this stuff he's clearly not, like an athlete or a cool kid. You can tell it bleeps him up inside. Of course, the best cure for feeling bad for Nathan is to actually talk to Nathan. Then you remember what a wonderful, punchable face those Prescott jeans give him. Or gave him. Now that's funny that he's, like, actually just semi-bad, because in the original game, he's complete jerk. Like, worse than jerk. Okay. So this we've got, and then we got free candy. Shit to tag. Oh, so we have to tag these things? We still have all this to do? Did I miss stuff, or are we not even halfway through this episode? Because this is... we're on 3 hours now. Lost Unicorn? I didn't take down the poster in our room. Maybe I was supposed to take this down. David? I don't know. Drama nerds. Moving canvas. Dead white guy? I don't even know what that's all about. Okay, this is that thing we read. Oh, all the only two things. And that. Yeah. So what about this one? So what is this happy 2 month anniversary? Are they going out? Or 2 months of what? 2 months of her in Blackwell? I don't know what it has to do with. Okay. Alright, let's go in. Am I supposed to tag more stuff? I mean, I don't know. You know, let me... I can actually run. Let me look at some spots on the wall over here.
I'm officially out of excuses to stay out here. Must mean it's chemistry time.
No, we have to tag stuff, don't we? Nope. Alright. I don't know if I missed something, you know what I'm saying? What's that paper? Can I pick that up? No? He got his thing out?
Alright, Chloe. Better head in. Chemistry won't bore itself.
Yeah. Maybe it will. I'm not sure if there's anything else. Let's go in. Anti-drug poster. Marijuana cigarettes kill.
That pic would actually make a sweet tattoo.
Without the letters, without the words. Look at the entrance.
Maybe if I delay going inside long enough, Blackwell will be overrun by future excellence. And by future excellence, I mean mole people.
Ha! Cool, mole people. Oh, Rachel Amber.
Good. You're here.
Oh. Hey, buddy.
I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father, I have broke your hest to say so.
Good. Admired Miranda. Indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... many a time the harmony of their tongues hath I listened to...
Hayden, you're killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
Mr. Damn. Keaton! Sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
It's ripped.
Rachel looks awesome. This is getting as surreal as last night.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Exquisite Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... my affections are then most humble.
I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective.
I guess that's supposed to be ripped.
The question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
Huh. I think Miranda's an idiot.
Miranda's an idiot because falling in love is stupid.
What is she, 12?
Actually, she's about 15, so your point, whoever you are, about being an idiot or being naive,
whoever
is
I am?
Well taken.
Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Say by the bell.
I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
You got paid, dude. Shut up.
I'll just be a minute.
Okay, so why am I here again?
Yeah, really.
Could you grab my belt for me? I think it's in my bag over there.
Yeah, sure.
She looks at us strangely. Okay, so...
Okay, get the belt. Don't say any stupid shit and don't, like, fall down. Should be doable, right?
Is this the room that actually gets turned into where Max has her photography class? Because this is the... Well, probably not. But the... I can't help but notice the desk is in the same position in the room. The door was there, and there was also a window there. And there were windows all along here, but there were more of the, that opened, like, vertically.
Hey, now. Sharing is caring.
I wish I could, like, move things around. Pencils for stage manager only, aka Steph.
To internet or not to internet?
That is the question.
I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings.
You've seen that already.
Why do theater kids take themselves so seriously?
Rachel Amber praying Prospera in The Tempest. A newcomer to Blackwell Academy, Rachel Amber blew the doors off her audition with a heartbreaking reading of Blanche from Tennessee Williams' A Streetcar Named Desire. Other interests include athletics, debate team, boosters fundraising, local history, and nature. Rachel hopes to one day grace the stages of Broadway and the silver screen of Hollywood. Spoiler warning, she does none of those things, I'm pretty sure. Nathan Prescott playing Caliban. A favorite son of the oldest and most influential family of Arcadia Bay, Nathan hopes his performance of The Tempest will only further the legacy of the Prescott name at Blackwell Academy. Playing Caliban has been a challenge for the sophomore, who enjoys sports, photography, and casual hangouts with his many friends. Oh, nice. Dana Ward playing Miranda. A sophomore, Dana has performed in two other productions at Blackwell Academy since her freshman year. Dana enjoys football, Go Bigfoots, social media, and school dances. She hopes to be a member of the Vortex Club when she's a senior. Hayden Jones playing Ferdinand. This show marks the introduction of Hayden Jones to Blackwell Academy's Drama Club. He auditioned on a dare and, as it turns out, actually really digs acting. A sophomore, his other interests include playing sports, herbals, and taking long walks in the woods. My guess is maybe, decrease the herbals and, read your lines. Memorize your lines. Juliet Watson playing Ariel. Juliet's primary interests include journalism and social activism, but she is very excited to be debuting this spring in the role of Ariel, the capricious and powerful spirit Prospera has enchanted and bound to do her magical bidding. Sounds like a very fantasy-oriented play. Travis Keaton directing. A veteran of Broadway, Travis Wilbury Keaton serves the prestigious Blackwell Academy as a teacher of the dramatic arts, mentor, and friend. He hopes this humble reinterpretation of Shakespeare's masterpiece can inspire the next generation of the country's leaders to strive for greatness and to never forget his motto, Ars Gratia, O Gratia Artis. Which means something about art. Stage manager Steph Gingrich, check crew Adam Glenn, Gina Yile, Stella Hill and Jason Redford, sound design Brooke Scott, program cover and poster Evan Harris, special thanks to Principal Wells, Rose Amber, oh, is that Rachel's sister? Carolyn Prescott? Don't remember Carolyn Prescott. Helen Christensen, Bernadette Hoida, Samuel Taylor, and especially the Prescott Foundation. Oh, but of course, we have to lick their boots a little bit more.
This poster definitely says something.
Yeah, it says Quell. Is this where her belt is? I don't want to find the belt just yet. Let's look at this. R.A. will suck as Prospera. If V.C. had any talent, maybe she would have gotten the part. Is that Victoria? Talent? Is that what you got Mr. K to cast you, slut? Really?
R.A. will suck as Prospera. If V.C. had any talent, maybe she would have gotten the part.
Talent? Is that what got Mr. K to cast you, slut?
Because they don't call it Drama Lab for nothing.
Well, I wouldn't have read that if I knew she was going to read it all herself. Blackwell Theater. Chemistry? What's on TV? I'm hungry. Let's play some vids. You're a slob. Where were you? Let's talk.
Okay, Chloe! So. My pants get lonely without my belt.
Oh. I can think of another thing to do with your pants. Did I just say that out loud? We can't leave. We're doomed. What's this poster say? Unknown. It's a dish.
I guess the Prescott donation doesn't cover this.
Pencil fund? We got props?
If I'd known acting meant getting to play with weapons, I totally would have auditioned for the Tempest.
No. Shakespeare is my homeboy. Drama is life.
Should be life is drama.
True. Pepe?
Sweet caller, Pepe.
Nah. Is that where her belt is?
Did you find the belt? It should be in my bag.
Alright, we'll go there last. It's in the bag.
Must be 100 costumes in here. Am I the only student who's not in this show?
Not necessarily everyone's gonna look at it.
Rachel Amber. Drama star and guardian angel. I still can't believe that was her last night.
Yeah, pretty far out, huh? Halo for Rachel.
Save my life. Get some ink.
So she already has horns. Now she has horns and a halo.
Definitely an improvement.
A note.
Sometimes you just gotta turn up the heat.
Where are all the pencils? I knew it was you, Hayden. Another note.
I'm gonna guess it's from Logan.
Dana, you are very beautiful. Do you want to go out? I would be into that. Logan, guess who? Logan, guess who? Scribble out, but you can still read that. Amateur. Beware of wild animals.
Rachel asked me to get her belt. I guess it's in the other room?
Yep, and I guess we can't go any further than that. Alright, let's go get it. Now that I've looked at everything, was there something on this side? No. There is stuff written now. The cast of 09 rocks. Woohoo!
That's the nicest backpack I've seen in my life.
Hmm. Is it? What that?
Rachel looks so happy here.
Aww.
There's Rachel's belt.
There's that skull, too. It shows up and stuff.
Guess I'll go give this to Rachel now.